안녕 친구!
Right now, since we're in mid-September, Korea is in its autumn season. But when I filmed the past 47 KOL travel videos, it was winter. And winter in Korea is cold with capital letters. It typically lasts from December to February. So what should you wear when you go to Korea during its chilly season? First off, how trained is your body? If you come from cooler climates, Korea might not be very cold at all. However, if you're born, raised, and living in a warmer country, come extra prepared. I've seen native Korean girls wear skirts on the coldest winter of days, with bare legs. But me? I'm bundled up.
Keep in mind that the northern parts of South Korea tend to be chillier than the south of South Korea. Thus, Seoul will be colder than Jeju Island.
Let's take a close look at the people on the streets.
The locals tend to wear long coats. Length is important. Long coats help block cold air from getting to your core. Make sure to wear layers of clothing underneath. Under my coat, I wore a thin but warm down jacket from Uniqlo. It's also lightweight and can be tightly rolled up into a compact cylinder. And it comes with a casing. Under my Uniqlo jacket, I wore a button-up long-sleeve shirt and tank top. Make sure when you wear layers, they're on the tighter side. If your layers are too loose, air will seep through to your skin every time you walk. And for some reason, people tend to wear black coats. I suppose they like to keep it classy and timeless. A lot of the times, both females and males wear jeans and sneakers. When I wear jeans, I wear Heattech leggings from Uniqlo, but I found wearing thick pants lined with fake fur much warmer. When choosing shoes for Korea's winter, make sure the bottom has textured patterns. This will help your feet grip the icy ground, especially after it snows. Can you guess who has grippier feet here? Yuna or me? When I was in Korea, I wore boots, leggings, and a long coat. All these items were lined with fur inside. To top it all off, I also wore a scarf, hat, and gloves. Native Koreans would laugh at me and ask if I was going to Siberia. They might be used to the weather, but I sure wasn't risking to get sick on my trip. Better safe than sorry. When you walk around Seoul, you can't help but notice the surgical masks. Do these people have a contagious disease? Did they get surgery? Actually, I found myself wearing these surgical masks when the air got too cold. It could get humid in your mask, but at least the frigid air doesn't bite as hard. In addition, surgical masks lessen your cough when you're sick. If you haven't experienced snow before, keep in mind that it's more romantic watching it fall down than when it actually makes your clothes wet afterwards. When I was shooting an episode at Bukchon Hanok Village, it was snowing. Not too much, but just enough to get my clothes and backpack wet. Thus, I highly recommend getting a rain-resistant jacket. I ended up buying a 3001 see-through umbrella in Insadong, which let me enjoy the romance of falling snow without its lingering effects. If you underestimated how cold Korea's winter is and you gotta go shopping, check out Myeongdong, the shopping mecca, the underground mall of Gangnam Station, Yihwa Shopping District, and Hongdae's street stores. As for me, I got my green coat from a store in Yeonsinne. Towards the end of my trip, the weather was warming up. Or maybe I was getting used to the cold. Either way, I transitioned from jacket to blazer.
Hope this winter guide helps you pack for your next trip to Korea. If you're going during its chilly season, that is. In next week's video, you'll see Yuna and Judy again. I know you're all very big fans of them. So all the videos that they came out in, I spaced them out. And there's two more episodes of KOL Season 3. See you next Wednesday! 안녕, 친구!
Nowadays, the ceremony takes place 3 times a day during the afternoon for visitors. Hungnae-mun is the first inner gate. The vertical stones on the ground were lined in order of ranking where court officials would stand.
And those are little mini kimbap, fried kimbap, and odeng, tteokbokki, sundae, marigold corn, and he just put on the fire.